Ah, glitter. It's great stuff. You use it for one art project and suddenly it's everywhere. It's on your clothes and your hair, clinging to your arms.
And just when you think you've finally cleaned it up, you find a little more stuck somewhere.
So how and why are these tiny, shimmery plastic particles so sticky?
Well, it turns out it's probably a combination of a couple of different factors, like static electricity and good old-fashioned van der Waals forces.
Van der Waals forces are weak electrostatic forces between uncharged molecules.
They're why water forms droplets, why geckos can run up walls, and why tape is sticky.
See, even though a piece of glitter looks like a tiny flat disc to us, all surfaces have microscopic bumps.
So the molecules on the surface of a piece of glitter are going to interact with the molecules of whatever it's sitting on.
Even though uncharged molecules are electrically neutral, sometimes they can be dipoles, with a slightly positive charge on one side and a slightly negative charge on the other.
The dipoles attract each other, like how water molecules stick together.
So when glitter ends up on your skin, which is some water molecules hanging around, the glitter and water attract, and you are stuck being sparkly.
And when glitter is just sitting on a surface, those van der Waals forces are also creating very weak static friction, just a tiny bit of resistance.
Since glitter particles are so light, when you try to brush them off a surface, the resistance is enough that some won't slide off so easily.
Plus, if glitter does rub against another material, say skin, cloth, or fur, some negatively charged electrons might jump over from one material to the other.
One material will become slightly negatively charged, and the other will become slightly positively charged, so they will stick together because of static cling.
So be careful when you craft. It is really, really hard to get rid of glitter completely because of science.
Thank you for watching this episode of SciShow, which was brought to you by our patrons on Patreon. If you want to help support free science information on the internet, you can go to patreon.com/scishow. And if you want to keep getting smarter with us, you can go to youtube.com/scishow and subscribe.
You learn how tape works?
Well, if you think the answer is by being sticky, you're not thinking hard enough.
Sticky tape is what is known as a viscoelastic material, which means that it has properties.